Sorry, Professor Ikota was not feeling well, so he was not able to come here. So I'm presenting as a researcher on his behalf. So shakshuka, basically shakshuka is a dish in Israel. So Tel Aviv in Israel, it's a big city famous for Bauhaus architecture. It's actually called the UNESCO World Heritage Site. In New York, we have Vandal Graffiti Birth. This is the content, actually. And writing graffiti. People write on walls in Tel Aviv. So we call it writing graffiti. Then aesthetics to the ethics. Then writing graffiti park installation. This paper presents cultural research-based typography down in downtown in Tel Aviv on the famous graffiti walls. Graffiti walls flooding this multicultural metro city. The research process examines the vandal and illegal activities of the individuals and some underground graffiti groups. So basically, there are a lot of graffiti groups. They used to come in nights and just paint on the walls and make different kind of calligraphy and different kind of shapes. So this is there's a dish called shakshuka. It's a mix of microculture. Basically, because you put a lot of, Tel Aviv is basically about a lot of cultures coming together because a lot of youngsters come there, they stay there. A lot of people from different places, they come and stay there because it's called a young city. So, literally, is a dish of eggs, coated with sauce, tomatoes, chili pepper, onions, and cumin. Traditionally, shakshuka is served in iron pan with bread to mop up with the sauce. And semantically, it's a mixture of symbolizes the eccentric structure of Tel Aviv lifestyle, basically a metaphor. So it's a city of youngsters, everybody comes there. It's a club of high-tech gadgets, a lot of startups, around 700 startups, they actually nourish there, and it's all by youngsters, young people. So as you see, here are the MyWays is a most high-tech gadget and high-tech application which has been used there. So golden sand beaches, 2.5 million years visitors every year, and it's very famous. And Tel Aviv, it's called a white city. Basically 4,000 Bauhaus kind of design architectural buildings there, so that's why it's called a UNESCO World Heritage Site. They have the biggest buildings inspired by Bauhaus. The urbanized view, as you see, the buildings of different shapes, different kinds, from Jewish to Muslim, from Baroque to Bauhaus, and from Norway's skyscrapers. As you see the shapes in the buildings. So it's all inspired by different styles. New York. So as in New York, it all started with painting on the walls and hip-hop dance, and they have a lot of artistic culture which actually started by youngsters, young groups. And youngsters came together and started in the 1970s in New York, and hip-hop, rap music, the rhythmic spoken rhymes. DJ, breakdance, street fashion, graffiti, all these things. So people started painting on the walls. Randomly they come in masks, in black masks, and started painting on the walls to express their ideas, to express their feelings. Sometimes they used to write about poetry, sometimes they used to write about their own names, sometimes some messages, some political messages. So it all went like that. So hip-hop basically was originated by youngsters as a street pastime to express their poverty and violence under underlying city context. So as you see here, all the trains and buses, it's all like filled with the graffiti, with certain kind of writing style. During the 80s, a quality of life crimes throughout the New York identified as a problematic urban neighborhood. So whole things was totally, people were just printing on the walls, like writing on the wall. So what time came and actually the mayor of that place, he said, let's wash all our thing. And graffiti was like banned. Whoever actually works for graffiti has to pay fine and he has to actually go into the jail. So these graffiti gangs, they actually, they used to paint and cover the subway trains and such vandalism that consumes were frightened to ride. So they painted all things and in one wash everything is gone. So downtown writing graffiti themes. In Tel Aviv, there people actually do, youngsters actually started expressing themselves by writing about politics, writing about the dialogues between one and another. They used to do about poetics, some about poetry lines, about something nonsense or something like writing the word, the names of each other, right? Symbolizing, maybe making some symbols to express each other what they wanted to say about sex, about their own name. What they were, they started doodling on the walls. The whole city was actually just overcome by the graffiti thing. So graffiti underground, they used to use a stencil. They used to just take a, this is Hebrew, in the language used in Israel. So they used a stencil technique. They just used to make a stencil and spray it on the cans, with the cans. So these are cans they actually got in the market, but now it's banned. This is another, they're just, you know, overnight they used to come and paint on anywhere. As you say, they started coming up with different styles of the way they express their ideas, right? The different kind of writing style, they started using it. This is our images. The whole city was actually was covered by this kind of graffiti style. This is just to express their ideas because they were not able. People were not want them to speak like unopen. So they come overnight and they just express their ideas. So stop making stupid people famous. This is one of the ideas they express through their writing. So you see here, there was already a kind of background, typography, and then over it, they started just scribbled it out. The symbols, or writing these kind of messages, love messages, and political messages, and make some symbols around. So our idea is from vandalism to aesthetics, how these youngsters can give in a space actually to express their ideas, because if we actually suppress the youngsters with their ideas, they were not able to come out, won't be able to express their ideas, whatever they wanted to say. So from writing graffiti to installation park, basically. So there are graffiti writing techniques. So like from designing, like it's written shakshuka in English, then in Hebrew, and then in Arabic. So different writing styles. So we actually made it a kind of a 3D of it, take a 3D out of it, and from basically 2D image to actually take it out as a 3D thing and making it a kind of installation over it. So you can see it from top here on the right side, and you can see the third floor side view and the third floor view. And you can see the same thing in a 2D, English, Hebrew, and Arabic. So this is the installation we kind of created with this kind of idea, that people can actually use their language and use their style, use their typography, or use their writing graffiti style. In a kind of installation, so that everybody can express their ideas and it becomes more of aesthetically beautiful. So this is an idea of a theme park installation, where people can come. It's like Hyde Park in London. So people can come here, sit there, and it's a whole big park, you can see. people can come here, sit there, talk to each other, write on the walls. This small model which we created, you write on the walls in different languages. They can talk about, express their ideas, whatever they want to do, maybe with related to politics, maybe related to symbols, maybe related to some names or doodling or all these things. So we call it graffiti installation in the city park. BNG, the BNG installation is based on our culture sustainability approach of fostering the city neighborhood aesthetics and letting the varied minorities to express freely their own voice. So they can be like lower sitting, they can be like upper sitting, to sit and, you know, people can sit and have snacks and talk about things. So this can be a free park. And on top of it, we are using microLED lighting technology in a sitting center. At night when it will be dark, so the top part of it will glow like this. So it's like this technology is by Pierre Kelliger. He's a French biochemist, and he created this technique by illuminating the LED. You can actually create, with the help of photosynthesis, you can actually create a lighting technique which can actually glow, and it produces oxygen and takes carbon dioxide. So over a ton of oxygen is produced in a day, kind of thing. So which is like a kind of eco-friendly. There'll be light. There'll be like places to sit, and youngsters can express actually their own ideas and thoughts. So our idea is not to block the graffiti activities, but to set up in the city's park a new cultural activity of everyday and huge installation object for free writing activity in two levels, one for doodlers and for copywriters. This biomimic graffiti, BNG, is a shakshuka installation that open source mode when they are free spaces for everyone to communicate their thoughts by writing on given wall. People will come to enjoy the writing walls, get the varied messages. This will lead to professional output of graffiti copywriters. These activities will magnet typographer and graphic designers to use these new urban formats professionally. From this point, we presume something new will be created, the birth of environmental typography as a cultural ecology. This change will foster all kind of copy graffiti, the visual sensibilities, and point. This expressions will contain outer and inner worlds of ideas, moods, feeling, experience, responses, passion. The objective voice will communicate better. With this, we'll try to actually create a kind of a eco-friendly environment graffiti into installation where everybody can come and participate and be a part of it and freely express their ideas. That's it.